It's a pleasure to be back in Israel and to have this opportunity to visit with my friend Ehud Barak, a true warrior statesman and someone I've known and respected and worked with for over 20 years. I would start by joining President Obama in condemning yesterday's terrorist bomb attack in Jerusalem, as well as the rockets and mortars fired into Israel from Gaza in recent days and even today. The thoughts and condolences of the American government and the American people are with the victims and their families. We underscore that Israel, like all nations, has the right to self-defense and to bring justice to the perpetrators of these repugnant acts. In my meeting today with Minister Barak, in addition to discussing these attacks, we discussed a range of important defense issues, both in our bilateral relationship and across the region, including the dramatic political shifts taking place in the Middle East and the implications those changes hold for the future, Iran's nuclear program, the security environment on Israel's borders, including southern Lebanon and the Palestinian territories, and the ongoing military operation over Libya. Our bilateral relationship and this dialogue is so critical because, as Minister Barak once said, Israel lives at the focal point of some of the biggest security challenges facing the free world: violent extremism, the proliferation of nuclear technologies, and the dilemmas posed by adversarial and failed states. And I think it important, especially at a time of such dramatic change in the region, to reaffirm once more America's unshakable commitment to Israel's security. Indeed, I cannot recall a time during my public life when our two countries have had a closer defense relationship. The U.S. and Israel are cooperating closely in areas such as missile defense technology, the Joint Strike Fighter, and in training exercises such as Juniper Stallion, cooperation and support that ensures that Israel will continue to maintain its qualitative military edge.